everybody. Jacob Hoffman here. I was just recently challenged to do a 5-day vegan challenge by my friend Helen. She said I didn't have the willpower to be vegan for 5 days, so I will be vegan for 5 days. I think this challenge will be really easy. The only hard thing will be, you know, to stop my cravings for 1, Jimmy John's, Qdoba, and 3, biggest one, probably Chick-fil-A. Those 3 things will be hard to, you know, refuse, but other than that, I think this will be easy. Garrett, any remarks? Okay, yeah, all right, let's get into it. Day 1.
Day 1 of the vegan challenge. Let's do it. Okay, so I normally start my breakfast off with eggs, but that's produce of chicken, so I can't have that. So right now I'm kind of looking for a granola bar. Perfect. Nature Valley, baby. We're golden. Okay, time to go to school. Breakfast, I'd give it a solid 8 out of 10. I normally eat eggs for protein or a frozen sandwich. Just heat that up in the microwave. But I will go to school now, so I'll catch you at school lunch and we'll see what I'm having then. Okay, we're at lunch now. Got salad, you know, hardest thing ever because I couldn't get cheese, chicken, or eggs, or everything else that I put. This challenge is proving to be a lot more difficult than I thought. It is currently 4:27 in the afternoon. Have not eaten since lunch. I was craving a burger after my internship, but I grabbed another granola bar. So, I get a really bad feeling that I'm gonna be living off of these for the next few days. Okay, it is officially dinner time. I had a salad for lunch, and now I'm having pizza crust and tomato sauce for dinner, but we have officially made it to a full 24 hours of being vegan. Just get ready for day 2. Now that I got my footing down, this challenge is going to be so easy.
You're going to be so hungry.
I already am so hungry, Mom. Day 2 of the vegan challenge. You know, we gotta eat breakfast. I think I have something special to make today. No more granola bars. Thank goodness. So, let's go do that. Okay, so for breakfast number 2, glass of water again. And I made some toast with some peanut butter on it. It is now dinner time. It's 8:55. I am definitely struggling on trying to figure out what foods to eat as like an actual meal rather than eating 10 granola bars throughout the day. I mean, this is the number one thing I'm struggling with, is actually like getting enough nutrients and calories in my body. So I think I need to talk to an expert about this. Hi, Kaylin.
What's up?
The usual. What about you? Cooking, I hear?
I am, yes.
So, I just have a few questions for you.
Sure.
I was wondering, how long have you been vegan, actually?
I have been vegan for, it'll be 2 years next Friday.
What tips do you have to beginners?
Well, I would say, so for me, I went like cold turkey, pun intended. Like, I just cut all of it out just right away. But a lot of people have to kind of take it step by step. So a lot of people start as being pescatarian, where they cut out everything but fish, and then they go to vegetarian. Because, like, the dairy, honestly, is the hardest part. The meat wasn't hard for me, but the dairy was really hard. So I would say if you're the type of person that needs to, like, go step by step and can't just cut it out, then that would be my first tip. My second tip would be to do your research first, because a lot of people try to, like, just take the plunge into it, and they don't really realize when you cut out all those different animal products and everything, there are nutrients that you're missing. So a lot of people just try to, you know, eat the quick things, like, oh, I'll just have, like, 17 fruits and I'll be fine. But that's not how your body works. Your body needs, like, all the parts, like, all the proteins, fats, and carbs to keep you going.
Yeah, I actually did that. Like, I went in just full on. I mean, it's only 5 days.
Yeah.
So, I mean, my body will be able to handle it. Yeah, I actually did that. Like, I went in just full on. I mean, it's only 5 days.
Yeah.
So, I mean, my body will be able to handle it. I'm definitely noticing, like, I am not getting the same calorie count as I am before. I'm not getting the same, like, protein. And I'm an athlete, so
yeah.
I'm burning a lot of those calories, and I'm not getting those calories back. So, I mean,
you definitely have to eat more.
Yeah, and, I mean, day one, I had 10 granola bars. and a salad.
That's what I'm saying.
It's tough. I mean, you know, I was going in really confident, thinking it would be easy, and not even halfway through, and I am learning the struggles.
Absolutely.
So definitely, like, athletes, I'm assuming it must.
There's protein in vegetables and fruits and grains like oatmeal and quinoa and all that type of stuff. So it's possible to get all of your protein. It's just, you can't just eat a chicken breast and be done.
It's not as easy.
You have to be more intentional with it. So,
So you really have to plan things out.
Absolutely. Yes, you do.
What are some quick little things you can cook up, like smoothies, I don't know, salads, you know, like, what are those quick and easy stuff?
The smoothies, definitely. Those are really quick and easy. You can get your greens in that way, fruits, and you can have protein powder in there. You can put pretty much anything in a smoothie and make it taste good. Oatmeal is another go-to for me. That one's really protein dense because of the oats.
Well, thank you very much for letting me take your time.
Yeah, absolutely. No problem. Talk to you later.
See ya. Okay, Kaylin said a lot of great things that, you know, really stuck with me on actually being vegan and everything. The biggest thing that I should be doing is taking it little steps rather than jumping head first into this. But yeah, I mean, like, I jumped in head first because my confidence level was so high. I'm thinking it's so easy. I mean, even day one in the video, I said, this is going to be so easy.
I think this challenge will be really easy.
And I'm noticing it's really not that easy to be vegan. Take time into actually becoming vegan rather than jumping into it, and do your research. I told her, like, I'm struggling with getting enough calories because I'm an athlete. I'm burning the calories. And I just can't eat enough because I don't have enough things to eat, or I didn't have enough knowledge of what I can eat. She said, you know, you can take rice and there's protein in that, and you can mix it with some vegetables. And I mean, you can get protein in anything. It just takes more of that certain substance rather than just a full-on chicken breast. So that was really great to hear from her. Kaylin, thank you. Your tips were awesome. I'm gonna just... These next few days are gonna be, I've got this, I can do this. I see him coming round a bend for me. Day three. Again. Riding for my soul across the creek. Oh yeah, I hear the hounds call. Going back between my eyes. Oh.
gotta outrun what's chasing me.
We did it! It is day 5 of the 5-day vegan challenge. It is the finale. This is it. This is the last 24 hours. Not even, because I'm just gonna go till 7 o'clock, because that's when I started. So, yeah, I mean, this is great. I mean, I'm really happy, you know. This has been a really long 5 days, and it's not even over yet. I know that. But yeah, I mean, I've learned a lot, which I'll cover. When everything's over, I'll explain everything I've learned, you know, what was easy, what was hard. But yeah, really, I am so happy that this is the 5th and final day. Let's get some breakfast to, you know, start this final day off right. I'm thinking get some oatmeal because that's what I bought. So let's do breakfast. Okay, so for breakfast, I got myself some oatmeal. About to head out with a friend. We'll be getting Vitality Bowls for lunch, which is an awesome place that sells like fruit bowls and stuff. It's really great. But yeah, that's my breakfast, is nice little vanilla almond crunch oatmeal. It's actually really tasty. But yeah, let's finish off this day strong.
We made it to Vitality Bowls.
Day 1 of being vegan.
No, it's day 5.
Day 5 of being vegan.
Yep, so about to chow these down.
Yep.
Can I ask him to cut it?
Can you?
Yeah.
I've missed that. I really missed that.
That's it. We're done. 5 days of being a vegan. It was long. Learned a lot though. I learned that if you want to be a vegan, you can't just jump right into it. It's the biggest thing. You know, you can get easily malnourished. So, you know, I'm gonna think twice before I give crap to vegans, because what they do is very hard. It's been a while since the challenge is over as I'm recording this. And since then, you know, I haven't really eaten Jimmy John's or Chick-fil-A, or I haven't even had Qdoba since the day of the video, and that was a vegan burrito. So I haven't even had Qdoba since February, and right now it's almost April. So, you know, I mean, being vegan gave me a really good cleanse and, you know, made me start eating healthier. So I definitely recommend it to all of you. Thank you for watching. And, you know, if you really want to try and be vegan for 5 days, I say challenge yourself. Other than that, this is Jacob Hoffman signing off.